Now in Nigeria, controversy continues to mount over the charges filed against Omoyele Sowore, the former presidential candidate and publisher of the online newspaper Sahara Reporters. Mr. Sowore is accused of 7 counts of treasonable felony and money laundering, as well as insulting President Muhammadu Buhari. Yesterday, a court ordered Mr. Sowore's release, but as at the time we were coming on air, he's still in prison. Earlier today, I spoke to Nigeria's Minister for Justice and Attorney General, Abubakar Malami. I began by asking him why the government was singling out Mr. Sowore.
So we have at hand a situation where someone that contested election and lost, and is eventually calling on change of government, revolution, and change of government through means that will be constitutionally recognized means. And to our mind, that constitutes a treasonable felony.
But isn't that a bit hypocritical? Because the man who was serving under President Muhammadu Buhari, he carried out an actual coup in 1983. In 2011, while he was the opposition leader, he called for protests akin to those that were taking place in Egypt.
Well, the Attorney General of the Federation, the issue before me is that of Sowore. So those issues that I'm not
sure. Sowore never called for a violent overthrow of government. He just termed his protest
a change of revolution
now.
A change of government by revolution, through revolution, what does it entail?
He did not call for a revolution, Mr. Attorney General. The title, the hashtag for his protest,
revolution now.
Revolution now.
Revolution.
He was not calling for a revolution.
And then now call on change of government through means other than democratic process.
One of the orders against him is also for insulting the president. Come on, Mr. Attorney General.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, treason is treason, and then if there is a case for treason, you are entitled, I mean, you have as a matter of obligation and right to present a case before the court. And for your information, we operate a kind of a system of government that recognizes the independence of the judiciary through three arms of government. So what we have done is to present our case before the judiciary, which enjoys independence and freedom to determine one way or the other. Not that we have taken the law in our hands by way of adjudging him guilty, but presenting him before judicial process so that he could be accorded an opportunity to present a counter case for the consideration and determination of the court.
Well, and I don't know that cases like this mean that the government's human rights record is coming increasingly under scrutiny and being criticized. I mean, sure, it's not the only one. The treatment of the Shia population in the country, for instance, Dadiyat Abubakar Idris, who is a well-known government critic who is in detention, and then there's also the case of another journalist, Abba Jalingo, who has also been in detention for over 30 days.
Well,
what are the government scared of? I mean, what are you afraid of?
When we talk of rule of law, it's rooted in constitutionality. So provided you are making an attempt to call for the change of government through means other than means that are constitutionally recognized, you are entitled to be arraigned, and then in arraignment, you are equally entitled to foot in your defense. If indeed the court finds otherwise, the government naturally recognizes it.